Welcome to Parents Corner. I'm host Mitchell Stevenson, bringing news and information for parents and caregivers from around Anne Arundel County Public Schools. We're well into the back-to-school routines. By now, you should know the schedules for your child, his or her teacher's names and email addresses, and your login to the parental involvement portal, Parent Connect. If not, I urge you to contact the front office at your child's school and get that username and password to stay up to date on the academic progress of all the students in your household who attend Anne Arundel County Public Schools. Each month on Parents Corner, I try to present ideas for parental involvement. This month, let's revisit the topic of homework help. A little later in the broadcast, I'll have our PTA tip of the month. When we talk about parental involvement, people often think that means being in your child's business all the time. But parental involvement isn't about hovering over your child and micromanaging his or her life or homework. It means checking in to make sure they know what's expected. That can mean logging into Parent Connect once a week to see what projects are due and helping your child stay on track with turning in assignments and making up tests and quizzes. Parental involvement also means providing resources and help when your child needs it. Finally, it means knowing how to help and not doing their work for them. In past episodes, I've talked about Universal Design for Learning, which is teaching using the methods that best help children all learn. Let's recap. Universal Design for Learning. Three things. First, Universal Design for Learning, or UDL, is presenting materials in multiple ways so that children have various ways of taking in information and knowledge. Sometimes this means presenting the same information in multiple ways so that everyone in the classroom has an opportunity to learn in their own best way. In a practical sense, this means that your child may come home with 8 different ways of doing their homework. Their job is to pick one and do it well. Second, UDL means using contrasting the means of expression so that students can demonstrate what they know in various ways. The right homework may look very different from one night to the next. Third, it means challenging students to showcase their knowledge in different ways to reinforce their understanding of the whole concept. This often happens in the classroom with students selecting the ways they want to showcase their comprehension. The point is, what you see coming home may not look familiar to you. For example, when I was growing up, doing a math problem was all about the process. Teachers weren't interested in making sure that the underlying principles and concepts were completely clear to us as students. If we could do the steps by rote and get the right answer, well, that was good enough. Maybe show your work in the margin for extra points. Now, educators are working harder to engage students so that they understand the concepts. They do this for a couple of reasons. First, learning the concepts gives children the confidence they need to move on to higher and more challenging concepts. In math, we're talking algebra or geometry or calculus. But the real goal is to give children faith in themselves to understand and enjoy their schoolwork, not be frustrated by it. That's the beginning of this message on homework help. Listen up, parents and caregivers. Don't do your child's work or projects. Frankly, when you do their work for them, you aren't doing them any favors. If you do their work, they'll never learn to do it themselves. The teacher will notice in the classroom, and finally, someday they're going out into the big bad world, and you won't be able to fix it then. So let's walk through the nuts and bolts of how to help your child with their homework. Have your child do their homework assigned to them, right from kindergarten. Generally speaking, homework assignments in Anne Arundel County Public Schools should amount to about 10 minutes per night per grade level. Why should my first grader be stuck doing 10 minutes of homework a night, you might ask? Well, if your child were to join the field hockey or lacrosse team, would you ask the coach why, as a 6 or 7-year-old, they might need to attend practice once or twice a week? It's essentially the same. Homework, or academic practicing, helps reinforce the concepts they learned during the school day. Let's go back to the sports analogy. Let's say the softball coach has reviewed the right batting stance with your daughter. Feet planted, eyes on the ball, hips into the swing. She hears the instruction, grips the bat, steps into the box. Hears the pitch, and she does it exactly like the coach said. Do you tell her that she got it right while she was doing it in front of the coach, and that means she doesn't have to do it again and again and again before the big game? It's the same with reading and math and history. Homework is the brain workout your child needs before the big quiz or test. It helps reinforce the material they learned in front of the teacher. It makes it sink and stick into their little brains. In addition, doing 10 minutes of homework as a first grader, 20 minutes as a second grader, 30 minutes as a third grader, and so on, prepares them for the rigors of homework that will greet them when they get to more advanced classes in middle or high school. As a parent or caregiver, you're reinforcing the time commitment, seriousness, and energy required to do homework will help your child's enrichment throughout his or her school career. Be supportive and encourage that homework starting at a young age. Next, help them to have the tools required to do their homework, even when you lead a busy life. Are you driving your other child to soccer practice or dance or wrestling? A few years ago, I attended a workshop with our guidance counselor on homework help. One of the great takeaways from that was the homework toolbox. It's a box that includes all the things your child might need to do his or her homework: pencil, paper, pencil sharpener, highlighter, erasers, paper clips, stapler, glue, colored pencils, crayons. When one child is on the field practicing, the other can be in the car or on the bench or bleachers knocking out that 20 minutes of homework. The tote can go with you anywhere you go so that there's never an excuse not to be ready. When little Joey says, "I don't have scissors, so I can't do my homework," you get to smile and say, "Here you go." Next, think about the way your child is. Is your child someone who gets off the bus and needs to go run around for an hour to burn off energy before sitting down to focus on homework? Give them that time before having them sit down. They'll be better able to get it done and over with. Is your child one of those kids who can only focus for 10 minutes before getting frustrated? For that child, set a timer for 8 minutes and check in. Do they need a snack or to get up and walk away for a few minutes? Can you distract them with a card game so that they can calm down before returning to their work? Does their homework time need to be broken up into 2 or 3 segments so that they can think clearly without crossing over into exasperation and anger? Does your child need total quiet and his homework spot is right next to the TV, where his 4-year-old sibling, who doesn't have any homework at all, is watching television and keeping him distracted? Does your daughter need to do math right when she gets home, but save her 5 minutes of reading time for bedtime? The point is, know your child. Know their strengths and weaknesses, and allow those character traits to help make homework time a success. Now, the final issue to tackle is homework help for long-term projects. Do you have a child who's a procrastinator? How do you help a child like that when you only find out about the project the night before it's due? Well, the long and short answer to this is that you use the online tools available to you as a parent. Know your login to Parent Connect. Check in once a week yourself to see what assignments are hanging out there. If your child is one of those kids who puts it off until the last minute, help them manage their time. Do it like this. Let's say it's mid-October and you go on Parent Connect, where you find out your child has an assignment that's due the week before Thanksgiving. That's about 6 weeks to get it done. Sit down with your child and make him define his or her own deadlines. Don't assign the deadlines yourself. That'll get you into trouble. Let them make the promise to themselves. Let them think it through. So you start a conversation. "Mary, I see you have a social studies project due in 6 weeks' time. Let's go through some of the steps and supplies you'll need to get it done." Mary says, "I know, Mom, I'll get it done. Don't hassle me." Here you say, "I'm not telling you to do it now. I want you to map out a timeline of deadlines for yourself so that you're not stuck doing it the night before. I see here that your teacher doesn't want you to use online resources. We're going to need a trip to the library to do your research. When do you want me to take you? Can you give me a deadline or a date so that we can get that done? Let's look at the calendar." At this point, you're giving them the opportunity to lay out a plan for themselves. Now, if they say they want to go to the library on November 20th for a project that's due November 24th, well, that's going to need a little more steering in the right direction. But you know how to do that, right? Great. We have a deadline for the research. Now you'll need supplies. Can you give yourself a deadline to get me a list of supplies and put that in your phone or on our calendar or agenda book so that you'll remind me to get to the store in time? We're well on our way now, Mary. This gives me a lot of confidence in you. Now let's think about a first draft and how much time you'll need for fact checking and editing your work. Let's add that to the calendar. From there, you just check in. Is Mary meeting her own expectations? Is she holding herself accountable? The final thing about homework help is that sometimes kids are going to fall short. Practice holding them accountable to themselves, but then give them the freedom to make a mistake now and again. TV host and comedian Chris Hardwick said that no human ever became interesting by not failing. The more you fail and recover and improve, the better you are as a person. Ever meet someone who's always had everything work out for them without zero struggle? They usually have the depth of a puddle. So help your kids. Give an assist, but don't do it for them. Now we're on to our PTA-PTO tip of the month. It's October, and for many parent groups across the county, that means membership and recruiting or the beginning of fundraising. I'd like to encourage anyone who watches this program to please join your school's parent group. You may not be involved in the day-to-day activities of the group, but your voice as a member strengthens the overall voice of parents in the school. And PTAs, reach out to people you don't know. Look for new parents at your back-to-school nights. Attend new student orientations and be welcoming to new families who come into your school community. They might bring great ideas and enthusiasm to your group. Think about diversity in your recruitment efforts. The Anne Arundel County Public Schools Office of School and Family Partnerships can connect you with a free translator to attend your meetings and help you translate your publications and printed materials so that everyone can be included in your message. Think about recruiting men into your group. Often it takes little more than asking to get them to join. Dads and stepdads and grandmas and uncles are interested in being involved and included. Sometimes they just don't know how to step forward. Making a special appeal to the men in your school can have big payoffs. Next, expand your network. It's easy for parent groups to become cliques. Your parent group needs to make a clear and conscious effort to avoid even the appearance of cliquey behavior. At meetings and back-to-school nights, wear name tags so you're readily identifiable to the people who don't already know you. Stand at the door and greet everyone instead of standing at the front of the room and conversing with the others on your boards and committees. Mix and mingle in the crowd and always ask parents about their families and children. You all have something in common if you're there at back-to-school night. Your kids! And finally, after your initial recruitment drive, reach out again. There's so much paperwork that comes home during those first few weeks. If you do a student directory, hit parents one more time and remind them of the benefits of joining a parent group. Getting a directory or the weekly e-blast or advocacy to the school or even the benefits and discounts afforded to PTA members and cardholders. And at each meeting, continually remind parents that they can become members at any time of the year. Membership doesn't close at back-to-school night. Finally, mark your calendars for November 14th's Family Involvement Conference from 8:30 a.m. to 2:30 p.m. at Anne Arundel Community College. Engage, empower, educate families and schools together. This should be a great opportunity to network with other families and educators. I'll see you there. Well, that's it for this month. I'm Mitchell Stevenson, your host for Parents Corner on AACPS TV. Thank you so much for watching.